All right, guys, I'm here with Cameron. Cameron, how are you doing?
I'm doing amazing. This is amazing. I'm finally getting to meet you. I'm finally in the backyard again. It was only 12 hours that I was here, so we're extending my time. So every minute here is like, it counts for me.
Okay, so give me, that was a crazy finale. Give me, what are you thinking right now? Did you expect that to happen?
No, I thought for sure walking into this finale that Paul was going to win like unanimously. I had no idea how everybody felt on the jury. I thought it was awesome that they decided to vote with how they felt. Like, part of the game is jury management. It's not like, oh, reward who played the best. It's like you have to evict people and still have them to like you to win the game. And, you know, Paul didn't do that, which is why he didn't win. And I'm kind of happy that Josh won. I was rooting for him going into this.
I know. We were talking about it on AfterBuzz that we didn't think this would ever happen. And here we are.
Yeah. The most unlikely guy from week one won. I thought it was ridiculous that he grabbed the golden apple, was like screaming, I'm not going home. And now,
look at him.
You know what? He's the prophet.
So you got to, you know, give a little message to your house guest tonight at the finale episode.
I know. That was cool, right?
Right. So where did that come from? Do you think they're kind of, you threw some shade. Where did it?
I know. What? Well, I've been throwing a lot of shade on Twitter. Like, I'm not holding back. So I don't know. It's just because I told them how badly I wanted to play, and they're like, we see this passion fire in you, and they're like, we're going to, like, give you this lob ball question. You can take it and run with it. And I was like, you guys aren't even playing for yourselves. Oh, my God. I was just so excited that they gave me the opportunity to just roast them. It was awesome.
Trust me. I think all of the Big Brother fan base says thank you for that one.
I was the first to tell them that they were.
Right. And I do have to ask, so you battled back against Cody.
Yep.
And he got America's Favorite. What was your reaction to that?
If only I battled back, I would have got America's Favorite.
Exactly.
No, I think Cody was awesome. Like, he was an original personality in the house. There's nobody like as stone cold in like whatever he does. He doesn't care about anybody else. I think it was awesome. I love his personality. So yeah, I think he definitely deserves the America's Favorite. Yeah.
Well, okay, you're a Big Brother super fan, obviously. What was the most surreal thing for you walking into that house? You walk in those doors, what, you're back in the backyard.
Yeah.
What was the most crazy thing for you?
I think the craziest thing for me was just like, you know, getting your bed, like all the normal stuff, like for a normal Big Brother player, everything was just surreal for me. Like doing a competition, just figuring, I'm here in the backyard right now with you. Like even to this like very moment, everything is surreal. I just take everything and I appreciate everything that was given to me.
And last question, I know you're a huge fan of the game. You study it, you know it, you know how it works when vets come back. What do you think Paul's biggest downfall was this season? Why did he not win that $500,000?
I think it's because he didn't own himself in the goodbye messages. He wasn't like, hey, I gotta get rid of you because you're a threat to my game. He would just say, hey, Christmas went rogue and got you evicted. It's not like he owned his game in the final speeches, and that's probably what got rid of him. Like, you could respect somebody that dupes you if they own it, but if you're just like, if you pretend like you just stumble into the end and you're like, oh, vote for me, it's like, nobody likes that. So you just got to own everything.
And last question, I know everyone's dying for it. If you get asked back, will we see you back in the Big Brother house?
Yeah, I don't care. I don't care what's going on in my real life. If they give me a call, I will come back. And I'm pretty sure everybody that's ever played will feel that way. It's like when you get the call, you're like, yes. So.
Well, I hope to see you back, and thank you so much, Cameron. Enjoy the rest of your night. Yeah, of course. Oh my God, I gotta give you one.